We found the three most burning Hey Arnold questions that are haunting your dreams.
Hey, Grandpa, whose glasses are these?
How did Helga keep a shrine to Arnold in her closet?
Oh, Arnold!
Who is the resident in apartment 16?
Mr. Smith.
How do the residents of the boarding house all share one bathroom?
13 boarders, one bathroom. What do you expect?
Let's start with Helga Pataki, the blonde bully of PS118 who is super obsessed with Arnold.
You trying to make me sick or something? Take your stupid hat and get out of here.
Okay. Thanks again, Helga.
I'll never wash these clothes again.
Which leads us to this burning question. What is the deal with her closet shrine to Arnold?
My sultry preteen, why must I hold you only whilst I dream?
As seen here, Helga moves her clothes out of the way to get to her statue of Arnold. So how did Helga manage to construct this shrine without alerting her parents?
Getting ready for bed.
Oh, okay. Well, sleep well.
Yeesh. And speaking of alerting her parents, did they not notice that she was bringing a bunch of random fruit to her room?
Helga! The door's locked, honey. What are you doing in there?
All right, Mother.
Okay, fine.
Like this large piece of watermelon that was used as Arnold's head.
Will I be forever enslaved by your spell?
How in the world did she manage to get that to her room unnoticed? And speaking of fruit, wouldn't that make her closet stink?
Trying to make me sick or something?
What's the amount of time fruit can stay in a closet without rotting? And what about fruit flies? Wouldn't they make an appearance due to all the rotting produce? How is she able to make all of this happen? And in her closet?
Why must I worship you and never ever tell? Arnold, you make my girlhood tremble.
We are left totally stumped by this one and cannot find a reasonable explanation as to how this can possibly happen.
I dance divinely. My eyes are lovely.
Let's move on to the question that has left us stumped since 1996. Who is Mr. Smith?
What do we know about Mr. Smith? Arnold, we know nothing about Mr. Smith.
Some people say he works for the government.
Satellite Industries. Sounds like the name of some covert cover-up operation for the CIA. I knew it. He's a spy man, I told you.
Let's take a look at what we do know about him. One, he lives in apartment 16. Two, he works for Satellite Industries. Three, he wears bowler hats. Four, he has quick and easy access to a helicopter. Five, he is technologically inclined. I don't know about you, but I don't think these five facts tell us anything about who he is. What does Satellite Industries do?
Sounds like the name of some covert cover-up operation for the CIA.
Is it a government agency?
I knew it. He's a spy man, I told you.
It has got to be a government agency, right? Why does he have access to a helicopter? Does this mean the boarding house has a helicopter pad?
That guy is unbelievable.
And what's with all the gadgets and technology he installed around the boarding house?
Now that's private.
Speaking of the boarding house, how is it possible none of his neighbors have seen him?
Tip, tip, tip. Guy's lived here 3 years. He's never said a word.
And I mean nobody.
It's creepy. He gives me the crispies.
Didn't Grandpa and Grandma have to see him when he rented the room?
Well, he does pay extra, Mr. Kokoschka. Hand on time.
What does he do when he isn't working at his, maybe, possibly, government job? Does he have a partner? Kids? Maybe a pet? Why is it that in 5 seasons of Hey Arnold, we only get about a 1 second glimpse of him? And why is he wearing a trench coat? It isn't raining out. What's in his briefcase? Is it important? Why bowler hats?
We know he always wears one of those weird bowler derbies.
Unfortunately, we have more questions than answers when it comes to this elusive resident. Okay, so 2 situations left us with more questions than answers. But maybe we can solve this last one. How in the world do all the residents of the boarding house share one communal bathroom?
I hate this traffic jam every morning.
The less than ideal bathroom situation was first mentioned in the episode Apartment 16.
13 boarders, one bathroom. What do you expect?
And has been making us scratch our heads since. I mean, think about it. You have Arnold, Ernie, Mr. Wynn, Oscar, Susie, Grandma, and Grandpa, and Mr. Smith living in the house.
Good morning. The thickest are back there.
And these are just the residents they interact with the most.
new borders. Need to take a number.
Do they coordinate their bathroom times? What if someone really has to go?
Hey, Gramps, did you drown in air or what?
Do they ever run out of hot water? Or worse, toilet paper? How can such a big place only have one bathroom?
13 borders, one bathroom. What do you expect?
Or maybe they don't. When looking at the episode Four-Eyed Jack, we discover there is a hidden bathroom in the basement.
Hey, can a fella use the downstairs bathroom in peace?
I didn't know we had a downstairs bathroom.
But unfortunately, Grandpa keeps it all to himself.
You think I want everyone finding out about my extra bathroom?
And Mr. Smith, let's go back to him. How has nobody seen him going to or from the bathroom?
What about Mr. Smith? He has his own private shower and a great big split-level suite.
Okay, that explains it. So there are actually three bathrooms, but one is private and one is hidden.
Oh, great. Now the secret's out.
Well, this one is partially solved. It still leaves us with the issue of the majority of the boarding house residents all having to use the same one bathroom available to them.
Hey, Gramps, did you drown in air or what?
Maybe there's another hidden bathroom in the house we don't know about.
Never eat raspberries, boys.
So, three questions asked, three questions left unanswered. Actually, we're left with more questions than we even started with. I don't know if anyone can answer these head-scratching questions, but one thing we do know, Mr. Smith looks awesome in his bowler hat.
Where do they sell bowler derbies?